aromatics over there, and then the coil inside that carriage. So when the magnetic field change.
So what do you call it? Magnetic rail, or?
I call it this linear motor. This is what we call magnetic track, and the other one calls coil.
Nice. So how fast did you say it went?
10 meters per second.
10 meters per second.
And it's the same technology you installed on the newest carrier.
Yeah.
The catapults. Same thing.
Just want to get a better shot.
It's more sophisticated.
Hey, the name of your company is
Chief Tech Precision.
Chief Tech Precision. So you can use this for basically all kinds of different applications of part changing.
Yeah, this is just a simple pick and place. It's going over to the build.
On that part? So you just randomly put it over there?
It's at the end of the routine right now. It's going to close the lid.
Nice.
Now we're going to be at the, this is the beginning of the program. We're going to open the lid.
So are these easy to program, or can you just like hand position it and record the positions and kind of go point to point?
Yeah, so it knows, it knew ahead of time where to find that part. It's not finding it automatically.
Nice.
Just a little victory lap here.
Yeah, that's just showing
not
off.
Not serving any. Yeah, just showing off. The,
yeah.
Well, the gripper. And so the last step, it's going to take that part and drop it. Then the best part, it's going to close the lid.
That is too cool, man.
It was, because
Sarah. What So y'all sell these machines, beam?
Yep.
So this took 3.5 hours to print right here?
Yep.
316 stainless, that's cool.
Yeah, so it's that was a single deposition with. On a larger nozzle.
Oh, okay, so you can just put it like in base mode, kind of?
Essentially, yeah.
Alright. So do you have to de-stress it or anything?
These are all as they came out of the machine.
Nice.
The residual stresses are a bit lower than the machine power a bit.
Okay, so this paintbrush was printed in 2.5 hours?
Yes.
Wow.
With that.
Okay, nice. So this is, so what kind of manufacturing process is this?
So this is a 3D printing polymer extrusion head.
Nice.
And it's inserted into a CNC machine.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I see. Yeah. I see. It's got a Cat 40 tool holder right here, so you can just put it in CNC mill.
So all of our products.
So can you put it in any CNC mill that has a Cat 40 tool holder?
Yeah.
Nice.
We retrofit machines so that you're able to do additive and subtractive.
Yeah. Okay, so these are laser deposition heads.
Mm-hmm.
They're pretty metal.
Yes.
Cool.
Yeah. So whereas normally when you are milling, right, you just subtract away, right?
Yeah, yeah. Just
or when you're adding, you just build up material, right? And then you have to send it somewhere for it to be polished and finished. Well, in our product, it ends up finished like that.
Nice.
All in one setup.
That is cool.
Isn't that awesome? So,
the model.
This is accurate to 8 microns.
That's what it did, the hole filling.
Oh yeah, that's good, man.
So like here I missed really the spot, nice. So I would, all I'd have to do is go back.
Yeah, go back.
Scan that part and it would add it right back in.
Cool.
So I could re-add it into the thing. So there's a few spots I kind of missed on it. Like, you know, I could have done a little better job right there. And, but again, I don't have to start over. And how long did that take?
Oh, 15 minutes,
actually,
10 minutes.
You know, if I sat down, it's faster.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm kind of lazy doing it. And now what it's just simplifying the mesh so you don't have to make triangles.
Nice. So what was this, laser centered or?
What's that?
This is SLS?
SLM. So similar to SLS, but what's metal.
Okay.
It's selective laser melting.
Melting, okay. Okay, cool.
Yeah, they actually have that machine running over there, and you can kind of peek in, you can see it.
Nice.
Hits it with...
This is a Renshaw?
Yeah, Renshaw.
Okay, cool. How long do you get took to print something like this?
That's probably going to be anywhere from 20 to 30 hours.
Desktop metal, which is a giant movement.
Depending on what machine. So they have a quad laser machine that would probably go about half the time.
I saw those guys over there, too.
Let me see that foot. Nice. What kind of material is that?
That is polyjet. It's going to be barrel clear. White.
Yeah.
It's going to be, they actually do that machine, what they call digital materials. So just like your printer at home, your inkjet printer, it mixes different colors together to get to a certain color. This does the same thing. So if you have like something that's really low on the shore meter, it's really flexible, squishy, they can mix that with a firmer material to get somewhere in between. Also, if you want transparent versus translucent, they can mix two together.
Nice.
Yeah, with the rubberized.
Yep.
The top print is one solid part.
What kind of material is that? Like flexible PLA or something? Or?
No, sir. That is both of these are photopolymers.
Yeah, it's gonna, that one's gonna be tangos on the bottom. What's that, tango black?
Yeah, so photopolymer. All
this
your
just got the rubber tread, the same as the cars from Rapid. Or no, this is Rapid.
And actual working exhaust.
Yeah.
Nice.